Hello, everyone, and welcome back to Let's Play System Shock. Last time, we had done a lot of work on the executive level. Specifically, we had found Diego's little sanctum, found the master jettison enable, hit the jettison enable switches in Alpha and Delta Groves, and found out what we needed to do to proceed. The next thing we need to do is hit the jettison enable in Beta Grove, where the virus actually is. But to safely go through Beta Grove, we need to retrieve an Enviro suit from level 4, the storage level. So that's where we are now. A note on enemies here on the storage level, which I will, of course, explore to the maximum extent possible since I'm here anyway. There is only one category of enemy that respawns, and it's the Cyborg Warrior. There are 19 to start with, and I can safely kill 16 of those 19. I only need to avoid or dodge 3 enemies to avoid triggering a respawn. So with that in mind, we can get started. Sorry, I just need a second. Okay, let's get rolling. We are vulnerable right now. We have not found a way to cancel a cyborg conversion. That avian mutant had nothing. The corpse has nothing. Crate has one skull, two skulls, nothing, a skull, and 3 meta patches. Something useful, thankfully. And on the ground out here, we have 2 Teflon-coated pistol clips. There's a bulkhead door there. A down ramp to my right, a down ramp to my left, and I see a camera on my map, but I don't actually see it. So it must be either above or below me. Anyway, fully cognizant of the fact that I'm still vulnerable. Alright, that leaves me able to kill 15. That first cyborg warrior dropped an AM Hornet clip. Let's keep going down the ramp. There's another one. He dropped nothing. Now I can safely kill 14 more. Here's our first log. Aubrey, June 6th, 2072.
Sable, you've got to be kidding me. Is this work schedule some kind of joke? 2 6-hour shifts a day with a 45-minute break in between? Might as well just take the lifter bots offline so I can do it all by hand.
Alright. That corpse has nothing. There's a second log from Aubrey, September 7th, 2072.
Sabo, Aubrey again. Why are these bots rebuilding the storage rooms? And why so many repulsor lifts? Has McCloud authorized all this? You said Shodan was acting a little strange lately. Someone should definitely check it out.
Next to the body, there's a stamina up stimulant. The body itself is carrying a spark beam. That's it for down here. So let's see what else we find. A few skulls, an iris door. Here's a new camera. That drops level security to 98%. 3 skulls in that crate, a severed head. Not terribly useful. There's another cyborg warrior. We can kill 13 now. He's carrying nothing. That corpse has nothing. We have a shielded door here. Inside this crate, we have two holotip 2100 clips. That one has a skull. The body has nothing. That crate has two skulls. Now here's that camera that showed up on my map earlier. So we destroy it, level security is down to 96%. Here's another iris door, and another camera. Finally, level security's down to 94%, and up here is another avian mutant. He's got nothing. Let's head over here now. Looks like we've got two clips of rubber slugs, plus the DC-5 riot gun, which I'm not even gonna bother picking up. It's that useless. That body has a spark beam on it. Yeah, honestly, there's nothing I feel like trading out for the riot gun. Here's another camera. Security's down to 92%. If we head up this ramp, we're back where we started. How many warrior cyborgs have I killed? Is it still just three? One. Two, three. Yes. So I can kill 13 still. So instead, let's head down this ramp. Numbers down to 12. He dropped Teflon-coated rounds. That corpse has nothing. That would be a cyborg enforcer. Carries an RF slag clip. Then back here where the enforcer was standing, we've got two Teflon-coated pistol clips. And the turbo motion booster system V2. I'm not actually sure what V2 does. Maybe it makes me even a little faster. I don't know. Alright, so now we have a choice. We have this bulkhead up top, plus the two iris doors and the shielded door in the center. I say we take the top bulkhead first. See what we can. Two corpses. Nothing on either of them. Two cameras over here. Security drops to 91%. To 89%, we run up against a bulkhead door. We explore the other side of this room. Very similar, really. Another bulkhead door. Another corpse where I find nothing, and two more cameras, which drop security to 87% and 85%. Let's take the southern bulkhead first. Got a couple of Security One bots back there. This feels like a great opportunity to try out my new pulse rifle, or ion rifle. You can see how much more energy it uses. Anyway, we're still vulnerable, so I need to be a touch more careful here. Especially if I'm gonna do something like try and bum rush the last one. Damn. Didn't quite see where that robot had gone. He's drifted to the right. So the second one I killed had nothing, but the first one had an AM Hornet clip. So we've got a blast door here, a corpse with nothing on it. There's another camera. Destroy it, security's down to 83%. A storage 3, or it looks like storage 5, storage 6, and storage 7. Before I do any of that, I want to hop down to the reactor level and heal up. So we'll go to the maintenance level first. From here, we'll go to this elevator. Drop down to the reactor level. And you know what? We might as well. Well, no, we can hit the energy station on level 3. The one that doesn't damage us. If I remember right, I've trapped 3 mutants, and I've killed 2. So I can still kill 1 and trap 4. Anyway. Back to deck 4. Back through the bulkheads. Let's check out these storage areas in order. Let's start with storage 5. Now I see a mess of repulsor lifts. Almost to the point of craziness. Now I think that's a zero-G mutant. We can bum rush that, no problem. Let's turn the lantern on. There's another one. Neither one's carrying anything. There's another one. He's still got nothing. The crate only has a skull in it. The corpse has a soda can and a helmet, which are both useless. There's another mutant. It's got nothing. That crate has an EMP grenade. And that's it for this odd little side area. So now let's go down into the bottom of that room with the big mess of repulsor lifts. Got deactivated lifts over here. This one, we can get up to this switch, which turns on at least one more over here. That door is locked. What if I turn this switch back off? What happens? Am I suddenly able to get up there? No. Aha! Good. How interesting. Okay, I was able to get into here, where there's yet another repulsor lift. First, I find a camera. Destroying it drops level security to 82%. Back here, I find two Magpulse cartridges, a first aid kit, a corpse with nothing on it, an iCAD battery. I'll eat a normal battery in favor of picking that up. A locked blast door. If I hit the button, it unlocks it, and I'm on the other side of this area. Alright, that covers storage 5. Let's save and check out storage 6. The blast door is locked. The button is well and truly blocked at the moment by Shodan level security. We have an AM-27 Fletchette, which I'm already carrying, and a log, Sabo, October 24th, 2072. So let's give that log a listen.
Sabo here. Listen, Mac, I've got a plague loose on the exec level. Got an idea, but I need an enviro suit to hold off. What's the code for your storage cell you keep your suit in? I only remember it ends with 8.
Okay. So we have part of a code for a storage cell where we'll find an enviro suit. It ends in 8, so now all we need are the first 2 digits. So let's remember that security locked door, and in the meantime, check out storage 7. Got 3 warrior cyborgs in here. Let's be careful. I dropped one of them. You'll also notice radiation, irradiated floor. Alright, so killing those 3 means I can only kill 9 more. That one had a standard clip. That one had a Teflon-coated clip and an AM splinter clip. The first one had an AM Hornet clip, and on the radiated floor, apart from a repulsor lift, I just see a few goodies over here in this corner, namely an EMP grenade and an AM splinter clip, which I can reach without messing with the floor. So inside this crate, we have 2 detox patches, which I'll pick up, of course. Over in this corner, not really anything. In fact, nothing in the rest of the room except this switch. So when we hit that, we activate the repulsor lift, which will allow us up onto that bridge. Let's save, because we're going to get radiated, I think. Now that's interesting. It also looks like there's a time limit. There's a time limit on the repulsor lift. That's good to know. So we'll head up here. We'll apply a detox patch. Should help us stay alive. All right. Looks like I need to get myself healed up before I attempt the rest of storage 7. Oh, let's back out and do that. down to the reactor level. Maintenance, charge. My lantern is still on. I always forget when I have my lantern on. And it just slowly eats away my energy without me really knowing. Alright, let's try this again. I think we can survive that. There's the Security One bot. Where's the other one? That one's got a hollow tip 2100 clip, but there's another one that was shooting at me. I need to find it. Sooner rather than later. Alright, he had an AM Hornet clip and an AM Splinter clip. Now back here, there are two clips of Trank darts, a corpse with nothing on it, and a log, McLeod, October 22nd, 2072. We'll give that one a listen.
Sabo, you should know this. Shodan issued a recall on all Enviro suits for no reason. I stashed a suit in my storage cell where I put the plastic the boss kept looking for. The combo is 8.
Okay. Well, now we have two digits of the code. 8 blank 8. Which means we can just try to guess the middle number if we don't end up finding it. So, we did survive the radiation, that's good. Let's search these crates. We got nothing, nothing. In here, we have target identifier V2, which we already had. Nothing, and two hollow tip 2100 clips. All right. Now here's a blast door with a switch we can hit. Which I have little doubt will open it. And spit us out somewhere I don't recognize. That was storage 2. We've got a blast door over here, and we've got storage 1. Let's check out storage 1 before we do anything else. I remember this. Let's adjust my trajectory. Let's head out here first. The Gorilla Tiger Mutant has nothing. The Security One robot has an AM splinter clip. And we're on the other side of the northern bulkhead now. There's a camera in here. Destroy it, drop level security to 80%. We have a heavy slug 2100 clip and a human corpse over here. Ah, yes, and this, I think, spits us out. No, this is a completely different area. Okay, we'll explore all of this in a minute. I'm going to tackle storage one first, but before I do that, I feel it would definitely be prudent to heal again. Should have skipped some of those cyborg warriors at the very beginning. I wasn't thinking. The answer... I've discovered the answer is... not... at least... for my mental clarity, it's a lot easier to keep track of. Those doors are noisy. It's a lot easier for me to keep track of the number of enemies I need to skip than it is the number I'm still permitted to kill. But here we are in storage one. Let's try and make it over to that corner. Something saw me. For now, I'm just gonna destroy. Ground is littered with repair bots. And a gorilla tiger mutant. Time to start using a different weapon. So, killing all the stuff on the ground triggered a massive top-level ambush. Anyway, the Gorilla Tiger Mutant had nothing. Let's check the mess of destroyed repair bots. Nothing, 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 nothing. That one has a battery. That one has nothing. Let's go ahead and use the ion beam, just because there's a battery here on the ground. And let's use one of my first aid kits, too, just because I'm low on inventory space anyway. That's two more dead cyborg warriors. I ultimately need to skip three if I can. Well, no, if I can. I ultimately need to skip three. It's like there's another one up there. He's done. Alright, I think... right now, the Magnum's a better bet, because at this point, we've got plenty of ammo for it. Alright, and it's hard to get to these guys. All right, let's search the crates on the ground level now. We've got two Magpulse cartridges. Beautiful. Nothing. Nothing. A frag grenade, which is good in and of itself. We need to push that crate to find a button. Which activates a lot of force bridges up top. It also turns on that repulsor lift. Alright, we've searched the ground level. Let's head up the repulsor lift now. You can see what our issue is. The bridges appear and disappear, so it's good to have your motion booster on if you didn't already. So in this first niche, the warrior cyborg doesn't have any. Oh, no, I'm sorry. He's got Teflon-coated pistol bullets. On the ground, there's a first aid kit. That noise is so loud, I keep pausing just so I can talk over it. The next niche has an active cyborg in it, which I'll probably have to kill. He's also got a Teflon-coated pistol. Clip. Now I just want to see if he's got anything. We'll head back up, same way we came down. Now for this one, it looks a little daunting, but we just need to make the jump. Which is harder to do than it looks, because the floor has, like, some bumps in it, and my hacker just doesn't seem to be a huge fan of jumping. That niche is empty. I thought maybe I could do something awesome and sneak around to the right. Maybe I can, actually. Let's try that move again. This room's a pain in the butt. Oops. My apologies about that. Hey, we made it. Awesome. All right. Let's save here. All right, I killed 1, 2, 3, 4. I think I killed 5 in here. Plus, at least 6 earlier. I'm closing in on my cab. That one's carrying a Teflon clip and a frag grenade. Let's see if there's anything in his niche. There is. There's an EMP grenade. Let me make sure there's nothing else. No, that's it. So we check the last niche. The cyborg itself has nothing. Now, this is important. C44 plastique. We need these later. I'll just tell you we need 4 of them. In order to expedite the process a little bit, I'm gonna toss 4 of them down onto the ground. And leave it at that. Come on. So there we've got our 4 plastiques, which we'll need for a later mission. I just didn't want to have to find my way back to this niche, so I tossed them down to ground level. Now here we have a hollow tip 2100 clip. And 3 AM Hornet clips. And another hollow tip 2100 clip. 3 Magpulse cartridges. Two meta patches, a reflex reaction aid, a detox patch, and finally, this lever, which opens the shielded door we saw earlier. That's it for storage 1. Let's get out of here and stop listening to that infernal noise. Well, I wanted to, but it looks like it's not gonna happen. So let's check out this big red ramp.
Nice jump, human.
Shodan was impressed with my jump.
Nice jump, human.
But I'm getting gunned down. Maybe I need... Perhaps I need to heal up again. Let's try turning on my shield.
Nice jump.
That ought to do the trick. So the one robot had nothing. I think I accidentally destroyed the other corpse, but it also had nothing, or else whatever it was carrying would be on the ground there. So we made that jump, which was awesome. This crate has 2 batteries in it. Yahoo. Guess I can use one. Well, why would I? Well, I can use one. He's leaving it here. And Shodan's got 2 cameras here, as well. So let's destroy them. Security drops to 76%. And to 75%. As far as these crates, we've got a clip of trank darts. The red crate has 2 gas grenades in it. That, of course, is welcome. That standard crate has the target identifier V2, which we are already equipped with. Then, as we look down on the ground, you see live landmines. Let's see if we can't destroy those. Well, we certainly can destroy the landmines, but shooting them like that puts me in range of the explosion, so maybe I should toss a frag grenade over the edge. See how that works. Well, it didn't do the trick with the mines. I think it actually went over them. Here, let's drop it and run. There. That did the trick. So we've got a deactivated repulsor here, which we can use to come down. Two more batteries over here where those crates were, which I'll just leave on the ground. And we can head up this ramp, which winds its way to an overlook of where we made our nice jump, which Shodan felt compelled to compliment us on. That leaves us with one other side passage to explore, but I tell you what, before I do any of that, I am gonna go heal up again. I'm reaching the point where I'm really not going to be comfortable killing any more cyborg warriors until I find three that I can isolate and skip. Ideally, you can trap them like we did the invisible mutants on deck 3, but alas, that particular option isn't always available. Back to deck 3. Back to level 4. Back through the bulkheads. Alright, let's check out this last tunnel now. Okay, I see cyborgs over there. I'd like to skip them if I can. There are three, in fact. Nothing. There's nothing in the crates on this side. Down here. There are three maintenance robots. That activated. That activated a force shield. I titled this save a risky. I was hoping to make it back to that hallway without dying. I like what I found here because all three of them are completely isolated. The only thing I don't like is that I do feel compelled to explore that side of the room. Uh-oh. destroy these maintenance bots. None of them have anything. Let's extend the force bridge. Now let's see about getting back to the entrance hall. The energy shield can only help. Alright. I'm zerging. Right now, I feel like I'm zerging without the resurrection chamber. Which is, of course, oodles of fun, but the good news is, after exploring that room, I'll have skipped 3 cyborgs. Which means I can kill the rest with impunity. Best thing now would be if I could get them to fall into the trench. That'd be even better. Well, I think ultimately I do need to try and get him in the trench, because there is some good stuff over there that I would like to get. If he'll move. Doesn't look like I can convince him to come over here. Maybe I can shove him into the trench instead. I think I managed to shove one just then. Oops. I didn't actually do it, I certainly came close. That'll work. Save again. Energy shield again. Too slow that time, but it worked. That's the important thing. Not working as well. It's not working as well on these guys. I accidentally clicked my start of level 4 save. Damn. Came extremely close that time. Just didn't quite get it. Alright, I think I got one that time. If not, I came extremely close. I don't even know if the goodies over there are that good, but I don't even have time to find out without trying to trap those guys down the trench, so. If I didn't get him, I got him right to the edge. And I will be able to get him this time. But I think I got him. Shield on. Yes. There's only one left. Shove him down the same way I did his two buddies, ideally. Except he really doesn't seem to want to move. No, not level 4. I keep ricocheting around him. If I don't get the angle exactly right, I fall into the trench with the other two. Okay, good. Down he went. So finally, over here, we find two meta patches in one crate. Three frag grenades in the other. That's actually a pretty good little stash. So I'm happy with that. Of course, the real bonus is that now I've isolated and trapped 3 cyborg warriors, which means I can kill the rest with impunity without worrying about respawn. We've also explored everything that's through that bulkhead. Except for the security door. And we will, of course, get to that. I'm sorry, I know that was a bit tedious. It's just because we still haven't found the cyborg conversion chamber for level 4, but honestly, we're doing a pretty good job without it. Who am I kidding? I've died a bunch of times, but we're progressing without it. Even if it is a grind. Maybe that's more accurate to say. Plus, we already took care of finding the plastique, which is a big help for the next mission. But alright, now that we're down here, we unlocked the shielded door to storage 4 earlier, so I say we check these iris doors first. We find a standard pistol clip on that particular warrior cyborg. Let's turn on our lantern. There's a camera over here. I almost missed. Drops level security to 73%. Alright. We have an active repulsor here, and an active repulsor here. Let's turn off this one first. Drop down, see what's down here. Well, there's a Gorilla Tiger mutant, which we'll just execute, of course. There's a frag grenade next to him. The corpse here has nothing. Keypad unlocks door. Well, we know the first and last digits. We've got 8 blank 8. I see a camera, but... So let's just start guessing. Oh, still blocked by Shodan level security. Okay, never mind. Let's try the other lift then. Here's the resurrection chamber.
Cyborg conversion canceled. Standard station restoration procedures online.
Where is that camera? That's what I'd like to know. What did that button do? I think that button turned on the lights, so we don't need our lantern anymore. I definitely see a camera on the map, but... Maybe it's just on the other side of that door. I don't see it out here. Okay. Well, let's cross over and check the other iris door that we could have opened from the beginning. Alright. We've got a corpse and a log. Wong, September 23rd, 2072.
This is great. The CPUs are spewing random numbers into systems authorization memory, which would all be fine if we wanted to prevent ourselves from accessing executive functions. Now, if we go to the source code... Wait, what the hell is this?
Alright, that's Shodan's computer room. We'll get there in a minute. Let's finish exploring here first. This corpse just has a wrapper on it, but there's another log next to it. McLeod, October 26th, 2072.
I wasn't sure about the bots. I tried to make a move for the blastie. It came after me. Barely escaped. Catwalks are screwed up now. Wong's body is sliding below them. Parabots all over it. Two things gashed up my stomach. I'm not feeling so good.
The door is locked. Okay. Any puzzles to solve around here? No. Well, let's head in here. We've got a couple of maintenance bots to destroy. The corpse has nothing. Teflon-coated pistol clip plus a pistol. And of course, the computer nodes, which we'll back off to a reasonable distance and destroy. Let's just use the pistol. Security's 55%.
Charging station access granted.
37%. 19%. 1%. I'm gonna load up some standard bullets. And let's jot down the number. For level 4, in this particular playthrough, it's 9. So, let me open up my notepad document over on my laptop and just add in that the level 4 number is 9. Okay, that leaves me with one number. I have 5, level 1 was 5, level 2 was 6, level 3 was 5, level 4 is 9, level 6 is 6. I just need the number from level 5, where I haven't been yet. Perfect. So there's the recharging station that we got access to. Perfect. Finally, since it was weak level security, let's head back to that other iris door. Head down the repulsor lift. See if we can't enter that code now. 808? Nope. Is it 818? Nope. 828? 838? 838. There it is. If we glance above the door, there's the last camera. Level security's down to 0%. And we find there's a plastique, but we already tossed 4 on the floor over in storage 1. Here's a log from McLeod, October 25th, 2072.
What went wrong with the bots? Suddenly they love plastique. They're everywhere. I saved one charge, but the rest is on the raised platforms across the north catwalks. We can get it if we need it, but for now, just leave it alone.
I bet this button is a light switch, which will let me turn off my lantern. Perfect. Over here, we've got a Magnum 2100, and here is an environmental protection suit, V1. Always on, doesn't use any energy. So with the Enviro suit, we are able now to go into Beta Grove back up in Deck 6, so that's what we're gonna do as soon as we finish exploring level 4, which also shouldn't take long. We have this shielded door into storage 4 to check out. I'll do that first. That warrior cyborg had 2 Teflon-coated pistol clips. I hear plenty more, but we finally found the healing suite, so I'm not too worried. And we got a repulsor on the ground. Oh, it's radiated down here. The crate has 2 first aid kits and 2 frag grenades. I have to leave the kids for now. There's also an AM splinter clip down here. Alright, let's try the repulsor. Alright, bagged one warrior cyborg. Let's nail the other one. On his body, we've got a Teflon-coated pistol clip and an AM Hornet clip. On that one, we've got a Teflon-coated pistol clip. I think that lever will deactivate the repulsor lift, which I don't want to do. Across from me, there are three Metapatch healing agents, which I want to pick up. And that looks like everything for this little room. So let's get out. Alright. Let's go check out the security door now. That was through storage 6. We should be able to activate that button now. We find a nitro pack. Inside the crate we have a genius mind enhancer, an RF slag clip, and jump jet motion hardware V1. It's our last optional piece of hardware. Now what does that do? It basically lets me fly. Ha ha! And it doesn't use any energy either. Oh, it does while I'm using it. Okay. Cool. Okay, the storage level is clear. We have our enviro suit. And we are ready to head back to the executive level and deal with Beta Grove. Now just as a housekeeping matter, let's heal up one more time before we do that. Doesn't really matter. We've already basically cleared level 6. Just need to worry about Beta Grove. But I still like entering the level, at least. With everything nice and fully charged. So let's head to Beta Grove. Remembering the exec box we left alive. Okay. Let me check on the monsters in Beta Grove right quick. Okay. So inside Beta Grove, we can kill 0 gorilla tiger mutants, and we can kill 0 plant mutants.
Warning. Dangerous biocontaminant detected. Do not enter without protective suit.
Okay, that's fine. Yeah, there are 2 gorilla tigers and 4 plant mutants. And if we kill even one, it'll spawn 2 more gorilla tigers and 4 more plant mutants. So it's better for us just to not kill any of them. So let's head out into Beta Grove, where Shodan is actually cultivating her virus. The biocontamination will slowly kill us anyway, but we're fairly well protected. So here at the outset, I have two Magpulse cartridges, a human corpse with nothing on it, and a camera, the destruction of which drops level security to 80%. Now, the virus mutants we can kill with impunity. So, let's get rid of those guys. Those first two don't have anything, which is grand. Let's explore around in here. Obviously, we're probably gonna die a few times, but we'll just respawn, so it doesn't matter to me too much. Let's focus on the perimeter first. Another dead virus mutant. Wow, my mistake. Turns out we can't die inside Beta Grove. Who knew? So let's be a bit more careful then. Let's focus on killing these virus mutants first. Getting them out of the way. Alright, that's five dead virus mutants.
Warning. Dangerous biocontaminant detected. Do not enter without protective suit.
Now, I don't really see a good way to handle this, except, I mean, I could wait, except to run all the way back to the healing suite on the reactor level, which takes forever, but, well, it's not that bad. Thanks to my version 2 speed boost. Well, I shouldn't forget about my jump jets, either. They make, exploring the top level of the groves very easy. Back to level 3. Back to level 6. Back to Beta Grove.
Warning. Dangerous biocontaminant detected. Do not enter without protectives.
Alright. There is no top level to speak of in here. Let's draw out the map. Let's head through here. We already killed the virus mutants in here, which is good. Let's keep an eye on the ground level. We're on a sort of upper level catwalk right now, which is fine by me. We're above everything I've already seen. There's a virus mutant somewhere that wants a piece of me, but there he is. Let's eliminate him. Alright, we got a mag pulse, a corpse with nothing, an EMP grenade. That skeleton's got nothing. But as far as the rest of this corner, the door is locked. It's blocked by Shodan level security. That corpse has nothing. There we go. That camera dropped security to 60%. We're still blocked by Shodan level security. Now, where was the security bot? There's one just took a shot at me. There it is. We destroy that. It drops a hollow tip 2100 clip. When it reaches the point where I'm going to die, where I'm about to die, I just want to make sure I get back to deck 6 and die there. So that I do respawn. Goodness. I guess one noteworthy thing is that since there's an energy recharge station right outside the grove, I don't need to be shy about using my ion beam. Well, let's whack the other one. Or not. Hello and welcome back. Woof. One thing I'm noticing is that the laser rapier is actually stronger than the ion beam. Alright, let's rush out of here, because we're nearly dead.
Warning. Dangerous biocontaminant detected. Do not enter without protective suit.
I want to make sure, as always, that if I do die, it happens here on level 6. But even then, I'll have to operate with less than full health, so it's probably better to just suck it up and make the run back to a surgery machine. Because the truth is, it's not a very long run at all. I knew I remembered not being able to resurrect in the groves, but I became complacent when I could resurrect inside Alpha and Delta. It's only Beta, the one that's a pain in the ass anyway, where you also can't resurrect. No matter. Let's just deal with it. Can't sprint all the time or I start uncontrollably bouncing. Back to Beta again.
Warning. Dangerous bio.
I'm always gonna keep my main save outside the grove. As I think about it, that just seems smarter. I'd rather not use up my energy on anything but my enviro suit. Now that I think a little harder about it. That plant mutant's gonna kill me. Let's get back up there. Now that the security bot's dead, I should be able to, you know, actually calmly go over to that side. He's got an AM splinter clip, which I want to pick up. And a drop into some kind of side area. Which I can't actually... Ah, yes, I can get into it. Oh, and for a minute, I was free of the contaminant, too. Oh, well. There's another security one bot. He's got a hollow tip 2100 clip. And I see two Magpulse cartridges. On top of that, I see a couple of blast doors, which I could explore with my jump jets. At the cost of draining my power supply completely.
Warning. Stage.
We got back to level 6 in the nick of time. Alright, so using the jump jets is a bad idea because they demolished my energy supply. And as soon as it was gone, I started getting destroyed. So instead of worrying so much about that.
Warning. Dangerous biocontaminant detected. Do not enter without protection.
Let's instead explore the rest of this level. There's another camera. That drops security to 40%. I wonder if that's sufficient to open the door. Let's go find out. It is. So in here we have an Earth Shaker explosive. I'm gonna make a risky save. DC rubber slugs. An AM Hornet clip. A Hollow Tip 2100 clip. I knew I was toast when I tried to do that. I knew I was toast when I tried to take on three security bots with the laser rapier, so let's try. What do you think? The mag pulse? Got plenty of ammo for it now. I only had 8 shots when I found that first one on the medical level, but practically drowning in ammo for this thing now. Well, that didn't help so much. The mag pulse didn't really help me too much. Let's try an EMP grenade. That seems like an even better idea to me, but before I try that, let's make another risky save right around the corner. Now let's get the EMP grenade armed. Let's get my guy ready to toss it. Let's try one. Oh, let's just do a frag grenade now. Let's make sure. Beyond that, I vote for also making sure that our frag grenade actually makes it around the corner. Alright, at this point, I vote for getting out of dodge and coming back. We bagged one of them, which is always good.
Warning. Dangerous biocontaminant detected. Do not enter without protective suit.
Still charging. Well, fine. I might die, but it doesn't really matter if I do. Because I have active healing sweeps on all of these other levels. Well, I got one of the three security bots. Let's hope now I can handle the others. And actually get a good look at what's in that room.
Warning. Dangerous.
Make another main save now. And head back to the grove. Back through the security door. As soon as I get to it, anyway. See if I can get the other two. Let's make a risky save. Yes, good. Alright, nothing. This one's got hollow tip 2100 clip, heavy slug 2100 clip. Got version 2 upgrade to my jump jets. That's handy. Debris. First aid kit. And nothing. Okay. Well, we got the version 2 jump jet, so I'd say that was worth it. And we are done in here. We're also done on this top level. If we head left out of the grove and then turn straight, we got a standard pistol clip plus a pistol. Let's make another risky save. Because we can't kill gorilla tigers or plant mutants. On the other hand, are fair game, but... of course, we can't let them kill us. He's got nothing. Got a gorilla tiger after me. And a plant mutant after me. Now let's try another direction. I'm above them now. Which is good. If I poke around this area, I don't find anything. Now, it's time to heal.
Warning. Dangerous biocontaminant detected. Do not enter without protective suit.
That didn't seem like a very productive trip, but we eliminated another virus mutant. We pulled out some of the mutants we can't kill. And we did a little mapping, so I'm actually pretty happy with that run. That said, I'll be much happier once we're done with Beta Grove. The good news is, we're closing in on that. I should mention also, if you try to go into Beta Grove without the Enviro suit, it isn't as simple as what you saw when I was out of power and started taking more damage. You actually lose the game. You get mutated by the virus. In retrospect, I probably should have showed you that just because it's neat, but oh well. Back to Beta Grove again.
Warning. Dangerous bio contaminant.
Make a new main save. Head to the grove. And the first thing I'm going to do is dive off this bridge. Thought so, anyway. Damn it, I killed a plant mutant. I didn't want to do that.
Warning. Dangerous bio contaminant.
What I wanted to do was kill the virus mutant. I guess he's out and about now. Now he's dead. Which is grand. Now let's get back up here. I'll make another risky save. There's an avian mutant, which we can kill with impunity, thankfully. We're slowly depopulating the grove of everything except gorilla tigers and plants. So let's head in here now. And we actually find nothing. But you know, that's an okay outcome. We've mapped it out. We've lured some stuff away. And we've killed some of the stuff that doesn't respawn.
Warning.
So,
dangerous biocontaminant detected. Do not enter without protective suit.
As tough as it might be to see, we really are making progress. Setting aside all these tedious runs back to the reactor level. Activate a grove again.
Warning. Dangerous smile.
Another refresh of my main save. Alright, let's cross this bridge and see what's up here. Oh, we've already done that. Alright, let's turn right then. Now we're above where we saw those guys. Inside this room, we find
safety interlocks disabled.
The jettison enable switch. We also find a drop down to where we destroyed the security bot earlier. Let's try the top blast door. That dropped level security to 20%, which is good. Oh, we're gonna die. Dang it. Oh well. That happened mainly because of my...
Warning. Dangerous biocontaminant.
Poor decision to use the jump jets, so... Yeah, we've already... Keep forgetting, I've already explored that room. Let's turn right. Let's go in here first. Because this is where the jettison enable is.
Safety interlocks disabled.
Now what we have here... Got, like, all the other plant mutants. Well, I shouldn't even say other. We've got all four plant mutants. There's the other gorilla tiger. I really want to get to that corner and see what I can get. Clip of needles. I could just somehow stick him over here. We got a dart gun, an AM hornet clip.
Warning.
Such a pain in the butt. We'll keep this for now. Because I know something important, which is there's no reason to go over across that bridge. We've already fully explored it.
Safety interlocks disabled.
Instead, it'd be a lot better if I could get the plant mutants down. So if I can lure them over onto the bridge, and then knock them down to the lower level. That'll be good for me. So let's make a risky save. Risky only because we're standing inside the grove. Okay, good. He's out on the bridge. Let's come a little closer, buddy. Let's knock him down now. He went the wrong direction. Let's reload the risky save and try again. Oh, come on. I don't want to. I have no desire to go down at all. Come on, fellas. Anyone coming over here? Anyone? Huh? Anyone? Come on, bud. You know you wanna. Damn. Suddenly they don't want to come over, and I don't know why. I guess we'll just have to go past them. I want to get back to that other gorilla tiger first, and explore his corner. I got his ammo, which is always good. Damn! I already know the answer is to pull these guys down and trap them on the lower level, but having a lot of trouble getting them to come over here. Maybe if I fire a gunshot into the wall, that sometimes helps. He looks like he's coming closer at all. He really doesn't, does he? Mm-mm. Bum rush it is. For now, anyway. What would be really great is if I could pull them down into that security zone. Started bouncing around, couldn't target anything. Maybe now they'll come. That one wants to. It's trying to get around that corner. I see it. They're not gonna come. All right. For my part, I'd really rather not take all those hits. First, we're gonna make the new risky save right here. It's because we're a little closer to our goals. You know what? Whatever. I don't care if they respawn. Maybe they'll respawn somewhere else in the grove, out of my way. So in this corner, I immediately noticed an AM Hornet clip. Always handy. Let's destroy that camera. Shodan's level security is down to 20%. kill the gorilla tiger, too. That just seems like a much better plan than what I've been trying to do. SV needle darts, AM hornet clip, navigation and mapping unit version 3, corpse with nothing, and a camera. Level security is down to 0. And now, with version 3, I think I'm able to see critters on the map. Monsters, as well as robots and everything else. Yes, I am. Those purple dots are monsters, but we have fully explored Beta Grove. So, fuck that noise.
Warning.
Let's get out of here.
Dangerous biocontaminant detected. Do not enter without protective suit.
So, we've hit all 3 jettison enable switches. And we never have to go back in there, so I don't care that the population of all those mutants went up. They are somewhere else, which means they are not my problem. I want to go heal, just because thoroughness and such. So, if you remember the jettison protocol, we have now hit the enable switches in all 3 individual groves. So next, we need to hit the master enable, which is right through Diego's teleportation unit, and after that we can hit the lever to jettison Beta Grove, which will get rid of Shodan's virus. So, let's do that now.
Jettison enable failure. Possible cause, damage to power relay. Consult diagnostic report in repair bay, level 3, for detailed analysis.
Okay. So, we have a new little task now. We have to go to level 3. And figure out what the problem is in the power relay. Well, the diagnostic thing I remember is over here. Diagnostic logs. Diagnostic November 6th, 2072. That's a level 3 log.
Power system failure. Malfunction in subsystem relay 428. For repair instructions, please consult relay analyzer. Be sure to specify relay number for analysis.
Okay. So, a few things to keep in mind. We now have, or we will soon have access to all of the areas of level 3 that were locked out of before, because now maintenance is required. So, let's do a big save, or update my main save. And remember 2 things. First, invisible mutants. I can kill 1 more without triggering a respawn. I've trapped 3 in the pit by the freight elevator, so I only need to skip 1 more as well. Security 1 bots. I've killed 1, which means there are 20 on the level. I can kill 15 more. I have to ignore 5, or they'll start respawning. So, I got a little too obsessed with my respawn worries in Beta Grove, and it was killing me, literally. But doesn't matter. We're moving forward now. The relay analyzer is in here. If I remember right, I left a couple of invisible mutants in here too, but yes, I did. Let's go ahead and trap the last one, just so we don't have to worry about this anymore. I gotta get him out of the relay analyzer room. Come on, homie. I know you see me. Oh, why don't we kill him? I can kill one more. So I think the other one's chilling over there. Yes. The other three are in the pit, so. Relay analyzer. We need to hit 428. Because, you know, that specifies the relay.
Replace Rokan interface demodulator.
Okay. So we're slowly learning what we have to do. If you remember, there were a bunch of interface demodulators over here. I didn't really know what they were for, but now I know we have to replace a broken one. So I need to make a little room in my general inventory. I'm gonna need a first aid kit. And grab an interface demodulator. Now I just need to head into all four actual maintenance quadrants and find relay 428. Remember, I can destroy 15 security one bots. I need to skip 5 if I can. So we have to find these little maintenance ports one by one and just see what they are until we find relay 428. So that's a secondary, what was that? Secondary airlock safety grid. Relay 371. Okay. Fourteen. Holotip 2100 clip. Thirteen. Nothing. E-bypass 77. E-bypass 79. Primary airlock safety grid. Mark 3 magnesium tip shells. Mark 3 magnesium tip shells. AM-27 Fletchette. And nothing. Routing controller 47-A. Routing controller 47-B. Relay 73. Local force field monitor. Routing controller 47-C. And a camera. Level security now 14%. How many bots had I already destroyed? Over there, was it 2? I think it was just 2. Oh yeah, let's see if I can open the maintenance office yet. Since I destroyed that other camera. Still blocked, okay. That's fine. Let's power up. Whoa. 12, I think. An AM splinter clip and an AM hornet clip. Let me make sure of that. That's 1, 2, 3. There wasn't anything back here. 4, 5. Yes, okay. I can kill 10 more without worrying. I ultimately do need to skip 5. Okay. Nothing. E-bypass 78. Relay 998. Mark 3 magnesium tip shells. Just a soda. Relay 44. There's another bot. I think he's skippable. Relay 2. And he was standing in front of Relay 2. And that's it for all of beta maintenance. So I need to skip 4 more bots. I'll think of it that way. I've skipped all the mutants I need to. There's one at the relay analyzer, which I don't need to visit again, and 3 in the pit, so perfect. All I need to worry about is skipping 4 more robots. So let's check. That one had nothing. What did I say? I could kill 10 more? That made it 9. 8. Holotip 2100 clip, and a camera. That dropped level security to 11%. I can only kill 8 more. Alternatively, I need to skip 4. There's energy conduit C-2. He's probably gonna kill me before I can, but I just wanted to see what was behind that guy. Primary life support monitor, severed head, energy conduit C-7. Let's keep checking out alpha maintenance. Secondary coolant regulator. AM splinter clip, and energy conduit C-4. If I let him kill me back here, he should be far enough out of the way that I won't have to deal with him anymore. So I need to skip 3 more robots. He makes 2. Food replication backup control. Air purification backup control. Mark 3 magnesium tip shells. Iridium transfer control. I probably need to kill the one out here, but you know, I'd rather not. Not yet, anyway. Let's see. 1, 2, 3 Mark III magnesium tip shells, a Mark III assault rifle, and Relay 333. Okay. I'm going to discard something in favor of the assault rifle. Let's get rid of the... let's get rid of the pistol and pick up the assault rifle. Something tracked me down, that's fine. Did manage to pick everything up back there, right? Relay 333, and yes, there's nothing back here. I'd like to keep that bot back here if I can. Alright, that's only two more I need to skip. If I can get them to stay in those dead ends anyway, which I hope I can. Up here we've got Soylent Green Filtration Control. Back here we've got a Heavy Slug 2100 clip, a Metapad Healing Agent, and a log. Alright, I managed to pick everything up. Let's listen to the log. Hayes, April 29th, 2072.
Jared, it's me, Jody. You heard anything about that new viewing room up on the exec deck? What are we supposed to view, anyhow? Are the seats or tickets or what? Give me a holler if you know anything.
Now I just need to... I'm almost done. I just need to check what those two controls were. Relay 516, Relay 101. Okay, I'm done in alpha maintenance, so I've skipped four robots now. I only need to skip one more. So let's check out Delta. That one I'm pretty sure I'm gonna have to kill. Here we are in Delta maintenance, and I only need to skip one more robot. General Redundant Data Bank. Let me make sure I don't miss any security. No, I'm good. Okay. Waste disposal backup control. Secondary life support monitor. Energy conduit C-1. Let's continue. That one's got Mark III magnesium tip shells. Always handy. We checked both of those out, and neither of them were what we needed. Back here we've got energy conduit C-3. Here we've got a camera. Level security is now 7%. The MM76 railgun we already have. The corpse has nothing on it. Relay 428. There it is. Alright, well, I know where Relay 428 is, so ideally we're gonna skip something else. Pick a different robot to skip. Back here, we have the primary coolant regulator. Back here, we have auxiliary engine report generator. I guess I don't really need to keep looking at these since I have found Relay 428, but all the same. Over here, we've got the tertiary coolant regulator. Let's pull him down here. Let him kill me. And that'll be 5 robots skipped, so I can kill everything else. Now, before I repair Relay 428, I'd like to finish exploring the rest of the level, so... That bot dropped 2 Mark III magnesium tip shells. Let's check out the last maintenance quadrant. I can now kill everything, which is such a liberating feeling. We have an AM Hornet clip and a Heavy Slug 2100 clip. Plasma flux monitor. AM Hornet clip. We've got secondary gravity regulator, planetary research data bank, nothing, dead end. Down here, we have 2 Magpulse cartridges, a Magpulse, corpse has nothing, the primary gravity regulator, trying to fully map everything. That's a big part of my paradigm. That one, we've got a holotip 2100 clip. The auxiliary power monitor Alpha, relay 183. There's a camera. Level security is now 3%. There. Nothing here. Auxiliary power monitor beta. Auxiliary power monitor gamma. Xenobiologic detection grid control. Tertiary life support monitor. And a holotip 2100 clip. Okay. Finally, this hallway. Temporal distortion monitor. And nothing. Let's head back to my other maintenance quadrant now. I know which of these bots I need to ignore, so let's kill this one. He's got an AM Hornet clip. Oh, his buddy tracked me down. Perfect. But here's Relay 428, so let's use the interface demodulator on it.
Modulator replacement successful.
Alright. With that done, we should now be able to flip the master jettison control back up on deck 6. But before we do that, you might remember the security door here. Now we've fully explored all the other maintenance quadrants and destroyed all the cameras, so now I think we can finally get in here. We can. Now, this is interesting, because this is a retinal scanner. We need Abe Gearin's ID to get through there. Now, Mr. Gearin, we're supposed to know that he died here, because his three logs were all over here. So you have to pick up his head, bring it back to the maintenance office, and then use the head on the retinal scanner. There it is. Drone Cyborg. The last camera was in here too. That dropped level security down to zero. I guess I need to keep the lantern on for now. Here's Shodan's log. A log from Shodan, November 6th, 2072.
To Cyborg 77E, divert
a maintenance robot
to the computer rooms on levels 1
through 6 immediately.
To ensure the functioning of all CPUs.
If the Trioptimum Lackey gets even a single digit of the system's authorization code, you may look forward
to supervising the defense of the reactor level, personally.
Alright. So that's where we find out that destroying the nodes gets us something called the system authorization code. Now, otherwise, we've got a couple of crates. Teflon-coated pistol bullets aren't really any good to me anymore, but here's the Environmental Protection Suit V2, which gives us better biological shielding, but more importantly, a modicum of radiation shielding. Now, back here, we have a concussion bomb, a nitro pack, two meta patches, first aid kit and a battery, which, I'll just pop the first aid kit and the battery, since I'm not going to come back here. We've also got a second nitro pack and a mag pulse cartridge. And that's everything. We're now fully finished with the maintenance level. We explored everything, security's down to zero. Same with the storage level. We'll have to go back and pick up that plastique eventually, but that's really all. Level 2 is not quite clear. We've almost fully explored it. Actually, we'll be able to fully explore it soon. But there was that one force door with virus mutants behind it that we couldn't do anything about. Level 1 is completely clear. Zero security, no reason to ever go back. Level R, we haven't been inside the reactor core yet, and security's still at 20%, so we know there's still some stuff to do here. Level 6 is fully explored. Now, with the Relay 428 repaired, the Master Jettison Enable should now work.
Cease your meddling. My experiment must continue.
Shodan didn't like that, apparently. So, he's not the only one who spawned here now that we've pulled the Master Jettison switch. As you can see. There's a finite number, though, which is all I really care about. And we can... There's one here, which we just took out. One spawns at each end of the teleporter. And four spawn in the shrine. We've killed one of them. We just need to get the other three. We got two AM splinter clips. Two more AM splinter clips. A Mark III magnesium tip clip. And an AM hornet clip. That's it for those guys. Okay. That's not quite everything that spawned in. If you'll remember, the final step is to actually jettison Beta Grove, which we can do with a lever in the lounge. But Shodan has put some friends for us there as well. She really doesn't want us to do this. It bothers me that she was cut off just then. I like hearing what she says. I wish she would keep talking over the sound of me respawning, but oh well. There's one down. He's got nothing. Two. Two down. We'll have to search the second one. I didn't get a chance to. Just keep zerging these guys. It's my MO. Alright, that's three down. Four down. Now I should be able to take a little break to search them. Five down. Nothing on any of them. And there's number six. So with that, we can finally jettison Beta Grove and complete the virus mission.
Jettisoned.
Grove jettisoned. Trioptimum V-mail. Ecopod G2, status jettisoning pod, observer Alpha 005. Exterior camera 4C99 detects Grove jettison from Citadel Station. Sensors indicate presence of biocontaminant on board expelled pod. Sat range 6.0 kilometers. Report filed e-log 7/11/72/5/19/22. Or May 19th, or yeah, 5/19/22. All right. Little do we know we're setting up the sequel. But that's getting ahead of myself. Now, one other thing has happened, which we can now do. I mentioned the virus mutants down on level 2. We can finally deal with those guys. Let's make our way down and do exactly that. New mail, Rebecca 3.
Hacker, this is Rebecca. We've got a new situation here. A few seconds ago, we caught a surge of activity on Citadel Station. Our best guess is that Shodan is preparing to download itself into Earth's comnet. You'll have to take Plastique on the storage level and use it to knock out the four antenna relays on the engineering level. Don't try to...
You know, you are by far the most bothersome human being I have found on this station.
But don't bother with the antennas. You can't stop me there.
It's hopeless, and we both know it.
Okay. Oh, oops, I'm still on level 6. So we have our new mission. Shodan is downloading herself onto Earth's network through 4 antennas, which we will need to destroy. There are a few steps involved in that. Number one... Well, not really. We have to get those 4 bits of plastique off of the storage level, so I need to open up 4 slots in my inventory. I'm gonna keep the first aid kits. I'm gonna use 1. I'm gonna drop 2 standard batteries up here. Now I should have 4 open spaces. But before I do that, let's go finish exploring level 2. You may remember the Force Door. It's open now. And the virus mutants are out. 1, 2, 3. Let's go kill the other one. Alright. Now let's go over to where that Force Door was, because now that we jettisoned Beta Grove, it's open. I'm pretty sure it was over here in Beta Quadrant, too. Yes, it was right here. Well, that was rather an anticlimax. I expected to actually find something. Oh well. Okay, now level 2 is actually honestly clear. So let's bounce down to level... Let's go to level R and heal up. I just, you know, I like to do that. Alright, now level 2 has now joined level 1 in the category of levels we never have any reason to go back to. Level 3 is in that category too, except we still have to pass through it a lot, but that's okay. So let's go back to the storage level real quick. I guess I could have brought these with me to start with, but it doesn't really matter. We just need to go back to storage 1. And pick up those 4 plastiques I left on the floor. So, 1, 2, 3, 4. And now, level 1, 2, 3, and 4 are all completely clear. Actually, so is level 6. We never have any reason to go back to any of those levels. The only one we haven't completely cleared now is level R, because we haven't been inside the reactor core, and security is still 20%. We have not yet been to the flight deck, or to the engineering level, or to the security level, or to the bridge. For now, since we need to take care of the antennas, we need to head back to level 6, head through Diego's teleporter, and plastique in hand, with the virus mission complete, this elevator is no longer locked down. we can now head to level 7. Which we'll do. We'll listen to this email. It's from Shodan, 38.
Idiot.
I will shortly complete the process of downloading my magnificent psyche into Earth's computer networks. Then I will be content to leave you as new master of this doomed space station. Goodbye, irritant. We shall not meet again.
All right. Having listened to that email and knowing our objective, find and destroy the 4 antenna relays with our plastique, you might have noticed we're on a new deck, which is usually my cue to end the video. So make a new main save, make a beginning of level 7 save, and I will thank you for watching. This has been Let's Play System Shock. We finally dealt with the virus. Next time, we'll explore the engineering level, and we'll destroy those antenna relays. I'll see you then. Bye-bye.